soil. Soil profile and types of soil. Soil is the skin of the earth. You know that soil forms the uppermost layer of the land. Soil gives the necessary nutrients to plants. The nutrients are what eventually help the plant to grow. Soil also gives support to plant body. That's why the soil is very base of agriculture. Animals derive their food from plants and grow. So all animals are dependent upon soil for their nourishment. In short, the life on the earth is possible because of the soil. Have you ever wanted to dig a hole to the other side of earth? If you try, then you will first dig through them some important layers of soil. Each layer has a particular name and has specific characteristics. This is called a soil profile. Let's dig a little deeper into the characteristic of each layer. When you dig into the soil, there are different layers of soil that scientists study. The different layers of soil are called soil horizons. They are called horizons because the layers are spread from side to side and each layer is different from the other. There are five main horizons in a soil profile: O horizon, A horizon, B horizon, C horizon and R horizon. O horizon. The first layer is called O horizon, which is called humus. Humus is decomposed plant and animals. This top layer has a lot of organic matter. The top layer means humus. As plant and animals decompose, they gather on the top of the soil and eventually mix into the lower layer of the soil. The O horizon is usually dark brown and is high in nutrients because it contains humus. A horizon. The second layer is the A horizon called topsoil. This layer has various minerals as well as organic matter. Many insects like spider and small animals like moles live in this layer of soil. It is a good medium for plant to grow also. When we talk of soil conservation, the top two layers are what we try to protect. Third layer is the B horizon called subsoil. It is a clay-like soil that has various mineral deposits such as iron, silicates and carbonates. This layer is not very dark. Tree roots grow down into this layer. C horizon. The fourth layer is the C horizon and is called parental material. It does not have many nutrients and is mostly broken up rocks. Plant roots cannot grow in this layer because it is too dense. Then why it is called parent material? Well, it's the material that other layers form from. R horizon. At the bottom of all soil profile is a layer of bedrocks or R horizon. This layer has a thick slab of rock such as granite, basalt, limestone, quartz and sandstone. It is underweathered parent material. Dig down deep into any soil and you will see that it is made of layers or horizons O, A, B, C and R. Put the horizons together and they form a soil profile. You can see soil profile clearly in many places where the land has been cut to form roads. Can you spot the horizon here? Now, types of soil. You know that soil is a lot of material mixed together, including dirt, mineral, animal material and plant material also. Soil is needed for growing plants and those plants are consumed by animals and humans. There are different types of soil and some other are better for growing plants than others. Clay. clay soil must be familiar to some of you. You have used it if you have ever made a project in art class with the help of this soil. Clay can be gray or red, and it is soil where the particle or very tiny pieces are packed very tightly together. This causes clay to hold water because water cannot pass through the particle that are so closely packed. While this may sound like it is not a problem for plant, clay is not the ideal soil for growing. Plant can rot in the water, does not drain it. If you ever travel to a beach, you have already seen this type of soil. This is sand soil. Sand is a soil type that is made of small pieces of rocks and minerals. So these pieces are quite large as compared to clay. As the pieces are large, so they do not fit together easily, and there are many gaps between them. There is a lot of air in this soil. Because of the water drain right through the sand, that means it is not the best soil for growing plants. While too much water will cause plant to rot, they also need some water or they will dry out. You know that clay soil holds too much water and sandy soil doesn't hold any water. So what's in between these two extremes? We have loamy soil. Loamy soil has a mixture of particles that are very fine and particles that are bigger. Loamy soil also has silt and humus in it. Humus is organic matter which makes soil fertile. Silt particles are medium size, so it drain and hold the right amount of water and is perfect for growing plants.